So, how are you?
Oh, my dear, in Jamaica, I would say, me dep on a blue fibrate.
Dep, say it again.
Me dep on a blue fibrate. That means I'm alive. I'm alive.
All right, now tell me something. A lot of the poems you talk about poverty. You talk about not having enough.
Yeah. You see, and the first one I wrote was on the tram car. We call it country tram, but it's market people taking the food down to feed the town. And they were relegated to the last four benches because, you know, there are baskets and bags and things. So they don't mind that. But they never liked to see anybody who could sit up front coming to sit there. I was not quite 14. I just decided to go in the back benches. When I walked in, one woman said to the other one, "Pread out yourself." And she just took her apron, you know, "Pread out yourself, one dress woman, I come." You know? I said, "My gosh. See, this is the language I should be writing in." I wrote the first set of verses. "Pread out yourself, Deliza. One dress woman I look like, she said, the lispier size that we are want to poke ourselves in there. Pread out, gal, should I come? No man has space in here at all. We make your fool, so Liza, pread out yourself now, girl, you know? And anyhow, I went to school and tried it out with my school friends, and they said, Louise, man, write another one. It sounds good, man.
So you really started to ignite something in people.
No, you see, when I used to go to school, they used to teach me to sing, "Do you ken John Peel at the close of day? Do you ken John?" Oh, yeah. Now, do you ken John Peel? We don't know who was Ken John Peel. In fact, I thought Ken was a name. I didn't know that Ken means, do you know? They did not say, "Do you know John Peel?" That said, "Do you Ken?" Them talking them for them language. There we were singing all these things. And there were all these lovely Jamaican songs, you know. And we never could sing them. Not in school. Oh, dear me, what a sad thing.